Yes? And who might you be? The Kin Lady is currently engaged. She's holding a conference with Shimmering's elite to discuss certain political matters.
Hmm.
Yes, so you do. And may I say that your outfit is suitably elegant. Please, head into the garden.
We all have concerns regarding the Queen's decree. I assure you that I am working with all Dark Takala to safeguard the sanctity of Shimmering and all of Summerset. Enjoy the food and drink. Business of the city requires my attention, but I shall rejoin you shortly.
I see the Queen's decree has even attracted some of our wayward brethren back to our shores. But make no mistake, Ultima or not, you're as much a newcomer as one of those cats or lizards. You heard that somewhere, did you? I'll have to have a discussion with the Divine Prosecution about how lax our security has become. No, I jest. The Kin Lady and I have nothing but the best interests of Summerset and the newcomers in mind. You really are well informed about things here in Shimmering, aren't you? For an outsider. Though your heritage might be Ultima, but you aren't a native of Summerset. You simply don't have the bearing and cultured air of a true child of the island. That's a serious accusation to toss around so casually. What did you say your name was again? I wanted to make sure to add it to the Divine Prosecution's observation log. For your own protection, you understand. I suddenly remembered some business I need to deal with as well. Feel free to pester the other guests in my absence.
How dare you barge into my home without so much as a by your leave? I'm sorry, Kerem, but I have no time for petitions or solicitations today. I have important work to get back to. Perhaps you can talk to my cousin. She's the canonreeve of our fair city. Such innocence. You really want to know why I oppose the Queen's order to allow newcomers to enter Summerset? Because I'm trying to protect both the island and the newcomers. It's in everyone's best interest that we maintain a separation. Aldark Tilkala came highly recommended. He has grand plans for protecting Shimmering, grand plans. Unfortunately, in my haste to deal with the Queen's decree, I may have made an error in judgment. Not that it's any concern of yours. But my Chancellor has been unable to verify the Aldark's existence prior to when we met. And I recommended him for the position at the monastery. I assure you, Kin Lord Millenthal praised Tilkala to no end. That's preposterous! Aldark Tilkala sequesters the newcomers to ascertain their suitability for life in Summerset. Those who pass will find a place here. As for the rest, they'll be returned to wherever they came from. That's what we agreed to.
My lady, one of the monks said to deliver this message. It's from the Aldark himself.
The Coral Forest.
Psst. Pretend you are adjusting your boot or admiring the architecture. As hard as it may be, look anywhere but directly at Raz. Good, good. Now, tell Raz what you learned at the Kin Lady's manor. Raz thinks Avanis is as naive as she is complicit, but she's not a murderer. This new Aldark, though, has so much blood on his hands, it looks like he's wearing red gloves. From what I could discover, he didn't exist before he came to Shimmering. The Coral Forest? A strange meeting place. Raz thinks we should go and see what the Aldark is up to. After I take back that outfit, I might need it again later. Ah, you have a pretty admirer, my friend. The Psychic Sage, yes? Here she comes now.
I'm glad I found you. While watching the King Lady's mansion, I saw her ladyship sneak out the back and leave the city.
The King Lady is meeting the Old Dark in the Coral Forest. Raz smells something, and it isn't moon sugar biscuits.
Your reputation precedes you, Eye of the Queen. I am Valserin of the Psychic Order, and I agree that the Aldorf is more than a simple monk.
We should work together, yes? But let's travel separately, to avoid attracting unwanted attention. Raz will find you both at the Coral Forest.
One of Somerset's more unique environments, the Coral Forest. I used to love coming here when I was growing up. We need to find out why the Aldorf asked King Lady Avanice to meet him out here. Based on what we saw in the monastery's undercroft, I'm hesitant to use magic to locate them. I suppose we'll have to find them through mundane means. Too bad the Queen's spy isn't here yet. I understand he's good at this sort of thing.
Let me show. Yagra, destroy these fools!
Razum-dar apprehended the Kin Lady. They're at the west edge of the Coral Forest. What happened to Aldorf Tilkalar? Did he escape?
I think we can conclude that Tilkalar wasn't actually an Aldorf. At least, not with his connection to the Prince of Bargain's Clavicus Vile. Strange magic and creatures worry me, however. Hopefully the pearl I sent to Artean can tell us more. You'd be surprised what a particular object can reveal if you know how to unlock its secrets. I need to return and tell Rightmaster Ikesis all that transpired here. If you're willing, I'd like you to come to Artean and confirm my story. The Rightmaster leads the Psychic Order from Kakora Tower on the island of Artean. This spell attunes you to a portal near Shimmerine, in the ruins of the Keep of 11 Forces. It always leads to Arteum, no matter the island's current location. One more adjustment and there, you are now attuned. Find me on Arteum after you finish with the Eye of the Queen.
Ah, Fiveclaw. The Kin Lady and Raz had the most illuminating conversation. Queen Irene will be disappointed that the Kin Lady of Shimmerine allowed a false Aldar to murder so many newcomers. Such a scandal makes other travelers uneasy about coming here, yes? The Prince of Bargains? That could only be Clavicus Vile. What Oblivion-inspired nest of vipers has Raz stumbled into? This one has a very bad feeling about all of this. Where is the Sijic Sage? Raz would like to ask her what she thinks. The Sijic Order's interest in all of this concerns Razum-dar. This one has never had much love of magic or those that practice the art. On the other hand, now Raz has his own person on the inside. An Eye of Raz, if you will, yes? Then you must go to Arteum and discover what the Sijiks have learned. When you return, you can tell Raz all about it so he can pass it along to the Queen. Yes, Raz likes this plan. In the meantime, Raz will investigate the Daedric connection.
Have you come to gloat? To kick me while I wallow in my own misery? Well, go ahead. I deserve it. I met him at Kinlord Millenthal's party in Eleanor. We had similar ideas about the Queen's decree, and I recommended that he lead the monastery. Summerset isn't a stewpot, and the various races aren't ingredients to be sprinkled in like so much spice. What a hateful accusation! Tilkala told me he was going to send them back where they came from. I had no idea he planned to kill them. I give you my word. I just wanted the newcomers to go away. And to find out he worshipped Daedra? How crude. I certainly hope not. We'll have to get the Divine Prosecution in there to gather up the monks Tilkala brought with him to Shimmerine. We can't have Daedric cultists desecrating a holy site. I suppose I need to beg for mercy from the Proxy Queen.
And there was no sign of Lathan. I don't know whether to be grateful or concerned.
We'll find him, Val. Now go check on the pearl while I speak to our new guest. What a rare honor Valserin bestowed upon you. Only a select few not of our order have ever walked upon this sacred island. Val tells me your aid was indispensable in uncovering the false Aldarch's plot on Summerset. Unfortunate, certainly. The magic you describe sounds familiar, though I can't quite recall where I've heard of it before. I fear the pearls may be a harbinger of the threat Sothaseel warned us about. Sothaseel, one of the living gods of the Dark Elf Tribunal. He's an honorary member of our order. After an attack on his clockwork city, he warned us about a Daedric threat to Summerset and Arteon. I sent Valserin to investigate. Indeed, but not until we finish studying the pearl Valserin brought us. There are mysteries to unravel, and Val believes you will be instrumental to our success. We can get started immediately, unless you want to explore our island first. The next step involves a thorough examination of the strange pearl you and Valserin recovered from beneath the Shimmering Monastery. Hopefully, we can learn more about the false Aldarch and the source of the pearl's magic. We are the Sigic Order, friend of Valserin. There is very little we cannot accomplish through the application of the old ways. Every object remembers its history. The trick involves selecting the correct ritual to reveal those buried memories. While I head inside to begin the augury ritual, I'd like you to go to Sothaseel's study in the tower, find my acolyte, Oriandra, and ask her for Sothaseel's amplification elixir. We may need it if the pearl proves to be resistant to our magic.
Friend of Val's, tranquil greetings, Caraval. You will forgive me if I seem awkward. We rarely entertain guests here on Arteon. I am Kelleris. Right Master Aikisis told me a great deal about you. I suspect he has plans for you within the Sigic Order. The Right Master holds you in high regard. That is proof enough of your worthiness. The Sigic Order requires practical wisdom, outside perspective. Eager to begin? Good. Eagerness is just what we need. Your first lesson begins now. The Order has detected a number of irregularities on Tamriel. Small breaches in the fabric of time. I would like you to seal them for me. The first cluster of time breaches appeared on the Isle of Summerset. You should start there. Go speak with my apprentice, Josaja, in the Athenaeum. She will provide a noble heart and a solemn commitment to the good. Too reclusive, I fear. As your knowledge of the old ways grows, only this. The map will show you the approximate. These time breaches are not visible. Precisely. I serve as the comparatively.
Yes, can I help you? Right, you're the Order's new initiate. I didn't expect you so soon. Things here on Arteum are normally, you know, snailish. I transcribed our seer's visions onto the map there, and collected these Sigic seals. The Augur, however... I don't. Please don't tell the Lore Master. It tricked me into dismissing the binding charms that keep it here. In the Athenaeum. Then it popped like a bubble and vanished. It escaped before, but never on my watch. Mercifully, yes. I just scried its location. It looks like it reappeared somewhere on the shores of Waston Coraldale.
didn't take long for some sea elves to scoop it up and squirrel it away. You'll have to steal it back. I am sorry, truly. I'm indebted. You'll definitely need the auger on your quest. Without it, you'll never find those time breaches.
Seals, fond of winged snakes and soggy chests. Noted.
Ah, fleshy, thick-thumbed biped. Hello. You're an elf, right? Or is it a man? I'm sorry. I have some difficulty telling you people apart. You're much less blue than the others. In color, I mean, not disposition. Anyway, what can I do for you?
Josage.
Wait, you're talking about that jittery mage I tricked into freeing me, right?
Oh, she's a delight. I had hoped for a longer holiday. Can only manage a leap like this once a century, after all.
I will. I'm actually quite comfortable here, mate. Cozy accommodations, the transliminal tones of the ocean waves, gangly meat brains to mock, but I guess I should be going. These elves plan to sell me. Can you imagine?
I'll help you. On one condition. When we're done sewing up these chronosymphonic when we're done sewing up these time breaches, you'll let me wander the Mundus in peace. No more dim-witted sidgics peppering me with questions. No more dusty shelves. You have a deal? Right. So, should we get going, or...?
Of course you do. Everyone has questions, and I have all the answers.
Fair warning, be specific. I'm bound to tell the truth, but truth can be a little slippery. You know what I mean?
I'm a traveler like you, except, well, nothing like you, to be honest. No offense. I'm what you might call an aspect, eh? Like an idea's shadow. Don't make a face, I'm telling you the truth.
Not my fault your language is so crude. I'm not in the skull. I am the skull. At least here on Nern.
Over in the adjacent place, I'm shaped like a throw pillow. Imagine that.
You look confused. It's just a trick of the light, mate.
The skull's what you might call a manifestation. Of me! Ah, this is just sad. Try this. Imagine a soul gem. Got it? Now imagine that the soul and the gem is also the gem itself. Weird, right? Ha! miming a head explosion.
You can't see it because I haven't got any arms, but it's happening.
I am. The unfortunate quirks of the Sigic binding ritual that brought me here. I'm free to lie as much as I like.
Unless you, or anyone else for that matter, ask me a direct question. Cheap trick if you ask me. They did. A bit. I'm certain I could break out if I really put my mind to it.
I don't blame them, honestly. If I was in their position, bobbing along like a little lost acorn in an ocean of knowledge,
I'd want to trap me too.
I guess, but instantaneous translocation's not like a Sundar scroll. The veil here in Mundus is all thick and sticky, you know? Like I said before, I think I'm grounded for the foreseeable future. Ah, well.
You were so funny. We're gonna have a really good time, you and I. Yes, in answer to your direct question, I do know a lot, and by a lot, I mean basically everything.
Well, an auger of the obvious wouldn't be very useful, would it? For what it's worth, I lobbied for something way more impressive. The resplendent skull of hexagonal wonders.
It was forcefully vetoed. No chemical taste, I guess.
Of course I do. Everything has a name. Names give a thing its shape. Birds, snowflakes, tea kettles, you get the idea.
I tell you mine, but you'd need about 6 more tongues and a pair of symbols to pronounce it correctly, so let's not bother. Fair enough.
So, where to? I assume you've got a map or something?
Oh, you're going to love this one. I'm seeing a tiny island surrounded by... It's either water or cats. Difficult to say. Let's hope it's the cats, eh?
You know, coral's just weird sack animal bones, right? So, this is a bit like a cemetery, I guess.
Ugh, you do not want to know what their ghosts look like.
Old cheese. I'll leave it at that.
Spooky clifftop estate. What a fine place for a breach. All sorts of ghastly things happened here. I can tell you that. I'd shudder if I had shoulders. I'm kidding, of course. Mortal fear is hilarious.
There's a breach here. City's a bit gaudy, eh? At least by mortal standards. Where I come from, this would be a little more than a preppy.
I'm kidding, of course. L&P's where I come from. More ruins. You know, every stone tells a story. I mean that literally, by the way. That wall over there won't shut up about how much it hates rain. Let's find this bridge and get out of here, eh? This breach is in a zoo! Wow! You know, I'm endlessly fascinated by animals. A bit like walking plants, eh? Except with more, you know, fluids. Ugh, what a word that is. A breach near the sea. Ah, I do love the ocean. It's a shame you can only see it in three dimensions. All the quasi-tones and endless number forms. Actually, I take it back. Your meat brain would explode if you saw this. Oh, I hear a breach nearby. You can't, can you? Count yourself lucky. Sounds like a swarm of bees bouncing around in a tent bucket full of sleigh bells. I'm sort of like that racket bards make. Breach nearby. I don't know why you're so intent on sealing them. Linear time is so overrated. Just imagine, you could die before you were even born. Wait, that's horrifying, isn't it? I'm sorry. Never mind. We'll be okay. We're running out of time.
Welcome back, Initiate. Have you done as I asked? Are the time breaches on Summerset Isle truly sealed? Well done. Well done indeed. You already seem well-versed in the cardinal virtues of our order. Altruism, foresight, precision in both thought and action. You will be a true asset to the order. Of that I am certain. Speak with Josarja. She will want to know that the Augur is safe, no doubt. Yes, I know all about its sudden disappearance. You did well in recovering it. I bade her give you something, your first step on the path. She awaits you in the Athenaeum.
Thank goodness you're back. I hope the Augur didn't give you too much trouble. I know it can be a handful. Now, the Lore Master asked me to give you something. The first of many gifts. The most valuable gift. Knowledge. Please, use it carefully. When I learned my first spell, I accidentally banished a toad to the far ends of time. At least I think I did. It hasn't come back yet. Congratulations, you've earned it. And my thanks. First-rate work in Summerset. Really, first-rate. Unfortunately, we have another problem. Are you ready to set out again? Our seers detected more of these time breaches, this time in the Iliac Bay region, my homeland. The Lore Master and I will keep searching for the cause of the disturbances. In the meantime, we need you to seal them. Yes, take this map of the region, more Sigic seals, and the Augur. I hope the breaches haven't grown more powerful. Stay safe, and just make sure Alakir weathers this, all right? I know, I shouldn't. I have to stay detached. Oh, never mind. May the old way guide your steps. The Lore Master was very impressed by your work in Summerset. He's a hard mer to know, but he's always been generous with his praise. I just wish I could be a better student. Well, not in the traditional sense. But don't get me wrong, I'm a very proficient mage. That's what caught the Lore Master's eye when he found me in the Alakir. I just struggle with some of the deeper lessons. The philosophy,